قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله، إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. The Sahaba radiallahu anhum, they would call this ayah arja ayah fi kitabillahi tabarak wa ta'ala, the ayah that grants you the most hope in the book of Allah Azza wa Jal.
Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله، إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. وأنيبوا إلى ربكم وأسلموا له من قبل أن يأتيكم العذاب ثم لا تنصرون. واتبعوا أحسن ما أنزل إليكم من ربكم من قبل أن يأتيكم العذاب بغتة وأنتم لا تشعرون. أن تقول نفس يا حسرة على ما فرطت في جنب الله وإن كنت لمن الساخرين. أو تقول لو أن الله هداني لكنت من المتقين. أو تقول حين ترى العذاب لو أن لي كرة فأكون من المحسنين. بلى قد جاءتك آياتي فكذبت بها واستكبرت وكنت من الكافرين. ويوم القيامة ترى الذين كذبوا على الله وجوههم مسودة، أليس في جهنم مثوى للمتكبرين؟ وينجي الله الذين اتقوا بمفازتهم لا يمسهم السوء ولا هم يحزنون. الله خالق كل شيء وهو على كل شيء وكيل. له مقاليد السماوات والأرض والذين كفروا بآيات الله أولئك هم الخاسرون قل أفغير الله تأمروني أعبد أيها الجاهلون ولقد أوحي إليك وإلى الذين من قبلك لئن أشركت ليحبطن عملك لئن أشركت ليحبطن عملك ولتكونن من الخاسرين بل الله فاعبد وكن من الشاكرين وما قدر الله حق قدره والأرض جميعا قبضته يوم القيامة والسماوات مطويات بيمينه سبحانه وتعالى عما يشركون ونفخ في الصور فصعق من في السماوات ومن في الأرض إلا من شاء الله ثم نفخ فيه أخرى فإذا هم قيام ينظرون وأشرقت الأرض بنور ربها ووضع الكتاب وجيء بالنبيين والشهداء وقضي بينهم بالحق وهم لا يظلمون ووفيت كل نفس ما عملت وهو أعلم بما الذين كفروا إلى جهنم زمرا حتى إذا جاءوها فتحت أبوابها وقال لهم خزنتها وقال لهم خزنتها ألم يأتكم رسل منكم يتلون عليكم آيات ربكم وينذرونكم لقاء يومكم هذا قالوا بلى ولكن حق كلمة العذاب على الكافرين قيل ادخلوا أبواب جهنم خالدين فيها فبئس مثوى المتكبرين ونفخ في الصور فصعق من في السماوات ومن في الأرض إلا من شاء الله ثم نفخ فيه أخرى فإذا هم قيام ينظرون وأشرقت الأرض بنور ربها ووضع الكتاب وجيء بالنبيين والشهداء وقضي بينهم بالحق وهم لا يظلمون ووفيت كل نفس ما عملت وهو أعلم بما يفعلون وسيق الذين كفروا إلى جهنم زمرا حتى إذا جاءوها فتحت أبوابها وقال لهم خزنتها ألم يأتكم رسل منكم يتلون عليكم آيات ربكم وينذرونكم لقاء يومكم هذا قالوا بلى ولكن حقت كلمة العذاب على الكافرين قيل ادخلوا أبواب جهنم خالدين فيها فبئس مثوى المتكبرين وسيق الذين اتقوا ربهم إلى الجنة زمرا حتى إذا جاءوها وفتحت أبوابها وقال لهم خزنتها سلام عليكم طبتم فادخلوها خالدين وقالوا الحمد لله الذي صدقنا وعده وأورثنا الأرض نتبوأ من الجنة حيث نشاء فنعم أجر العاملين وترى الملائكة حافين من حول العرش يسبحون بحمد ربهم وقضي بينهم بالحق وقيل الحمد لله رب العالمين.
بسم الله الحمد لله والثناء لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. أيها الأخوة, just a quick short reminder, inshaAllah ta'ala. The ayat that we recite in the salah from Surah Az-Zumar, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, the ayah that we started with, where He Azza wa Jalla says, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. The Sahaba رضي الله عنهم, they would call this ayah أرجى آية في كتاب الله تبارك وتعالى. The ayah that grants you the most hope in the book of Allah عز وجل. Where Allah عز وجل says, say, O Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام, O my slaves, who have transgressed against their own souls by committing all sorts of sins, the worst sins. Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying, do not despair from the mercy of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. Something to point out here. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, He's addressing His slaves who have committed all crimes, the worst crimes. But look at the way Allah is addressing them. He says, oh my slaves. He grants them the name of servitude, slaves. Because being a slave of Allah is honor, as I mentioned yesterday. And then Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, in order to call them back to Him, Jalla fi Ula, He says, my slaves. Attributing these slaves to Himself, Jalla wa Ala, honoring them even more. So that they turn back to Him. Do not despair from the mercy of Allah, Allah says. If that wasn't enough for you, Allah says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ لِلتَّوْكِيدِ. It's for emphasis. Verily, Allah جَلَّ فِي عُلَى forgives all sins. Every single sin out there. And then He جَلَّ وَعَلَى, He emphasizes it even more. He says, إِنَّهُ, verily He, هُوَ, again, emphasis. And He 100% definitely, الغفور. الغفور, this name of Allah, تبارك وتعالى, it means the one who is extremely forgiving. He forgives and forgives and forgives and forgives and forgives. It's min صيغ المبالغة. الرحيم, the most merciful. Again, min صيغ المبالغة is an exaggerated noun. It is على وزن فعيل, meaning He's the one who's extremely merciful and especially merciful to the believers. He's going to grant you that mercy. He's going to grant you that forgiveness without a doubt. But here's the call to action.
وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَكُمُ الْعَذَابِ ثُمَّ لَا تُنصَرُونَ.
أَنِيبُوا, الْإِنَابَةِ, it's a great act of worship, which is to return to Allah. And return to Allah Azza wa Jalla, command. Return to your Lord, وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ, and submit yourselves to Him. Return to Allah, and submit your will to Allah fully. Because in submitting to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, that is how you're going to save yourself. In it is salvation. مِنْ قَبْلِ, before the punishment comes to you. And then you have no one to aid you and assist you and help you. No aiders, no helpers.
وَاتَّبِعُوا أَحْسَنَ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ.
And follow, Allah says. This is the next call to action. You repented to Allah, you turned back to Allah, you sought forgiveness from Allah. You have taken the path of Allah, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Now the next call to action, it is follow that which has been revealed to you from your Lord, the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger alayhi salatu. Follow it, because that's what's going to help you stay on that path.
مِن قَبْلِ أَن يَأْتِيَكُمُ الْعَذَابِ,
before the punishment comes to you, but this time, بَغْتَ, suddenly. وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ, and you do not perceive it, you're not ready, you do not understand it, etc. You don't feel it. And then what happens?
أَنْ تَقُولَ نَفْسٌ يَا حَسْرَتَا.
As though the soul would say, يَا حَسْرَتَا, woe to me, I wish. Regret. عَلَى مَا فَرَّطْتُ فِي جَنْبِ اللَّهِ. It's going to regret all the shortcomings that is done regarding what Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala created it for, which is worship. It's going to say that I am amongst the losers. أو تقول, and it's going to say, لو أن الله هداني, if Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala guided me, I would have been amongst the muttaqeen, those who are good conscious. أو تقول, rather it will save the soul. حين ترى العذاب, when it sees the punishment. لو أن لي كرة, if only I had another opportunity, another chance. فأكون من المحسنين, those who die in disbelief, who die in a state that is not pleasing to Allah تبارك وتعالى, even if they were granted a chance to go back, they would do the exact same thing. It's just a statement that they're saying, because Allah says,
ولو ردوا لعادوا لما نهوا عنه وَإِنَّهُمْ لَكَاذِبُونَ.
If they were sent back, they would go back to exactly what they were prohibited from, but rather they're liars. But when the person sees the reality and there's no way out, he'll say anything to get out of it. But nothing will change even if they came back. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is the most just. He gives you enough opportunities for you to make that change, for you to rectify your state. All these opportunities that you're granted in this world, they are all the opportunities that you need. What it means is that if you do not do anything after all these opportunities are granted to you, even if you are sent back, you do the exact same thing and you wouldn't benefit from these opportunities. That's what it's saying to you. Bala, قَدْ جَاءَتْكَ آيَاتِي فَكَذَّبَتَ بِهَا وَاسْتَكْبَرْتَ وَكُنْتَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ. Allah says, our signs came to you, our verses came to you. You denied them. You were too arrogant to accept them, and you were amongst them disbelievers. وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ تَرَى الَّذِينَ كَذَبُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ وَجُوهُهُمْ مُسْوَدَّةٌ أَلَيْسَ فِي جَهَنَّمَ مَثْوًى لِلْمُتَكَبِّرِينَ. Allah says that today you see those who denied the verses of Allah and lied about Allah, etc., that their faces are going to be dark, black.
يَوْمَ تَبْيَضُّ وُجُوهٌ وَتَسْوَدُّ وُجُوهٌ.
That day that certain faces are going to be bright, radiant, and other faces are going to be dark. Those who believed in Allah and worshipped Allah, their faces are going to be radiant. And those who did the opposite, their faces are going to be black and dark. Rather, the criminals, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, is going to place a sign on them Yawm al-Qiyamah that they're going to be recognized by the angels. Allah Azza wa Jalla, I recited Salat al-Isha yesterday from Surah Taha. Allah Azza wa Jalla says,
وَنَحْشُرُ الْمُجْرِمِينَ يَوْمَئِذٍ زُرْقًا.
That we are going to resurrect the criminals that day blue. They're going to have blue signs on them. Those blue signs, the angels, they see those signs on them. And then when they see those signs, they know that they are the ones who are going to be punished. So they grab them, as Allah Azza wa Jalla says,
يُعْرَفُ الْمُجْرِمُونَ بِسِيمَاهُمْ فَيُؤْخَذُ بِالنَّوَاصِي وَالْأَقْدَامِ.
The criminals are going to be recognized and known by their signs. They're going to have signs on their faces. And then the angels are going to grab them by their forelocks and their feet and then crack their spines and throw them to hell. Ya'adhan billah. But others, the believers, the righteous, they're going to have signs. Even the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam is going to recognize them by those signs. He alayhi salatu wasalam, he says that my ummah, they're going to be resurrected yawm al-qiyamah ghurran muhajjaleen. That their limbs are going to be glowing, radiant, bright. Min athar al-wudu. Because of the wudu, the effects of the wudu they used to make. They do wudu properly. They wash their limbs. The Messenger alayhi salatu siyam al-qiyam is going to recognize them. And that's how he's going to welcome them to his hold, his pool. That he's going to quench their thirst. That they're never going to be thirsty after that. As for those who don't have those signs, they'll be turned away. That's what's going to occur. So Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is warning us about all of that in these verses. And then he tells us after that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, all of this universe that he created it for that purpose that he's worshipped. And that we're grateful to him. And that we are sincere to him in worship. We don't associate partners with him. If we do so, we'll be amongst the losers. And then he Jalla wa Ala goes on to telling us what's going to happen when the world ends. And then the people are resurrected when the horn is blown. And when the horn is blown and they're resurrected, what's going to happen? Only two parties.
فَرِيقٌ فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَفَرِيقٌ فِي السَّعِيرِ.
A party in Jannah and a party in hellfire.
وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا إِلَى جَهَنَّمَ زُمَرًا.
Those who disbelieve, they'll be dragged in groups to the hellfire.
حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا فُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا.
And when they arrive to the hellfire, the doors and the gates will be open.
وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا
The gatekeepers of the hellfire, they say, the angels.
أَلَمْ يَأْتِكُمْ رُسُلٌ مِّنْكُمْ
Then messengers come to you from you.
يَتْلُونَ عَلَيْكُمْ آيَاتِ رَبِّكُمْ
Reciting to you the verses of your Lord.
وَيُنذِرُونَكُمْ لِقَاءَ يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا
And warning you of this meeting that you're going to have today, this meeting. They're going to testify. They're going to say,
قَالُوا بَلَى
They're going to say, yes, that's the case.
وَلَكِنْ حَقَّتْ كَلِمَةُ الْعَذَابِ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ قِيلَ دَخُلُوا أَبْوَابَ جَهَنَّمَ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا فَبِئْسَ مَثْوَى الْمُتَكَبِّرِينَ
You'll be said to them, enter the hellfire for eternity. And this is the worst abode for those who are arrogant on this earth. On the contrary,
وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ
And those who feared their Lord, who are conscious of their Lord, who worshipped their Lord, who obeyed their Lord, who submitted to their Lord, they did what the advice that Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala advised them with early on in the verses, they followed it. They are going to be amongst those who are dragged and taken to their paradise in groups with those that they love, their companions, their beloved ones, their family members. They enter Jannah together.
حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا
Until they come to the gates. And the gates are open for them.
وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا
And the gatekeepers, the angels, they say to them,
سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ
Peace be upon you.
طِبْتُمْ فَدَخُلُوهَا خَالِدِينَ
You're pure. Enter it for eternity. And then what they do when they enter Jannah, they praise Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala just like they praised Him in the dunya. But then what's astonishing, ayyul kiram, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He ends the surah in the following manner. And if when you read this, it stands out to the one who reflects and ponders. Allah Azza wa Jalla says,
وَتَرَى الْمَلَائِكَةَ حافين من حول العرش يسبحون بحمد ربهم وقضي بينهم بالحق وقيل الحمد لله رب العالمين
Allah says, you'll see the angels. They are surrounding throne of Allah Azza wa Jalla, glorifying, exalting Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. Then Allah says, وَقُضِيَ بَيْنَهُمْ بِالْحَقِّ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ It will be judged between everyone with the truth, with that which is just and fair. And look at this.
وَقِيلَ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ
It will be said, أَلْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِ Who says الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ Everyone. Even the kafir who is heading to the hellfire, he says, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Do you know that? Everyone, Yawm Al-Qiyamah, will say, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. You know why? Because everyone testifies to the fact that the judgment of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, it is the most just. Even though they may not like the outcome, they know it is the fairest. So they say, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Look at that. Because Allah Azza wa Jalla was perfect, the most just, the most perfect in His names and attributes. And they see that perfection. So they all say, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. And that's how Allah Azza wa Jalla ends this scene that He gives us an image of in this surah, Surah Al-Zumar. We ask Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to make us from those who are saved on that day. We ask Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to make us from those who join the party of Jannah. We ask Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to make us from those who act upon these verses. We ask Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to forgive our sins. We ask Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to make us from those who hear this speech and follow the best of it. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make us from those who reflect upon His book. And we ask Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to make us from the people of His book. And we ask Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to have mercy upon us. And we ask Allah Jalla fi Ulah to make us from those who worship Him as He deserves to be worshipped. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to grant us sincerity in our statements and actions. Innahu wali dhalik wal qadir alayh. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Barakallahu fiikum.